Okay, then good morning again to all of you. So today let's start the discussion on this topic, increment boring. We'll discuss this topic today, right? Increment boring. And again, I'm told you this is for the theory and practical part also there. So you need to understand the things clearly. And again, if you have any kind of doubt in between the discussion, you can raise your doubts, right? So let's start. So first we need to understand what is increment boring definition generally, isn't it? Basic information need to be required to understand the subject matter, right? So now listen carefully and try to understand what is increment boring, right? So you know that what's the meaning of boring. First you need to understand the meaning of bore. Bore means, what do you mean by bore? Any idea? Have you know this, some mining activity or something like that, then the term bore has come into the picture. So if any student know the meaning of bore, yes, digging, or you are making a hole, right? That is bore. So similarly, increment boring, isn't, again you have to make a digging, or simple you can say that you have to make a hole, right? So what kind of hole you have to make, you need to listen carefully. So this, through this increment boring, what the things that a person has to do, or what the exercise that need to be conducted here in this increment boring, tree stem, listen carefully here, since we are discussing this forest mensuration. So tree stem has to be bored with the one instrument that is called increment borer. Is it clear? Listen carefully again. Let me throw the image. I like to explain you. We have a tree, right? And a tree stem. So this is a stem. We all know this is stem or bole, everything that is called it. And this tree stem has to be bored, or you have to make a hole in this tree. Tree stem with the instrument, right? The instrument name is increment borer, right? So using that increment borer, you are making a hole in this, and the purpose of doing this hole is to determine the increment of trees with annual rings. Listen carefully. To determine the increment of trees with annual rings, and to determine the age diameter relationship, right? So again, I'm emphasizing what you are doing, the increment of trees with annual rings. It means, again, you can perform this exercise only for those species or those trees which has a distinct annual ring, which has distinct annual ring, that is increment boring. Listen carefully again, increment boring is an exercise in which tree stem is bored with increment borer to determine increment of trees with annual rings and to determine age diameter relationship. Is it clear? That is definition. Again, I am repeating, listen carefully. This increment boring is a sort of exercise that need to be conducted on the field. Field means where the trees are there. It is a kind of exercise in which you have to bore the tree stem, right? We have to bore the tree stem to determine the increment of trees with annual rings, right? And then you need to determine also age diameter relationship. And from the definition, one thing one should always remember, that annual rings has been there in definition, right? So this exercise is confined or restricted with only those trees which has a distinct annual rings. So this is the definition of increment boring. I hope the thing is clear to all of you. Have you understand that? Increment boring. Fine. Now again, the purpose, as I told you, the objective must known, that ki why you have supposed to do this kind of exercise. So as you heard in, or as you discuss in the definition, that what you are doing there, we are determining increment of trees. So if increment is there, it means we need to know the past history, isn't it? Then we know the increment, past history of what? since we are counting rings, so ring will provide you, and we are also doing this edge diameter relationship, isn't it? So the purpose or the objective is to conducting this increment boring exercise is to understand the past history of diameter and basal area growth of trees. Is it clear? Again, listen carefully. What the purpose, what the objective we have when we are conducting this increment boring exercise, then our intention is to understand the past history of diameter and basal area growth of tree, right? And not only that, after that we need to generalize our exercise, right? So the purpose of generalization is that we can replicate all this kind of information to other areas or to other standing trees of same species with same site quality. Is it clear? Listen carefully again. Purpose is to know the past history of diameter and basal area growth, and after that we have to generalize all this information. What the information? Past history of diameter and basal area growth. Both the information should be generalized, right? So that we can use those concepts for other standing trees of same species and same site quality, right? And how you can do that? The very simple phenomena that you have studied in stump analysis or stem analysis also there, that edge diameter relationship need to be established by getting this information. Is it clear? Have you get that? Apart from that, you can also get some other information related to the area, related to the site, their climate, right? Flood or any other kind of external effect that has been already occurred in that particular place. So these are the basic purpose of increment boring exercise, right? I hope you all have get that. Or is there any question? Is there any question from anyone? Okay, Sangilam, listen carefully. Purpose. What the purpose or the objective? Listen carefully again, Sangilamu, you have asked the question. The purpose for doing this exercise is to understand the past history. Listen carefully. Past history. Right. What past history of what? Past history of diameter and basal area growth. Right? This is the first purpose, to understand the past history of diameter and basal area growth of tree. And the second thing is that after that we need to generalize what the information we are collecting in the first stage. We need to generalize the concept so that we can use the same information for other standing trees of same species and same site quality. Is it okay? And how the things can be done there? So you can do this kind of generalization by making edge diameter relationship, right? So through this past history data we are able to draw this edge diameter relationship. Then we can generalize this edge diameter relationship and we can use the same information anywhere if you have got the same site quality and same species there, right? And apart from that, through this increment boring exercise we are also able to get the information of some external factors also. External factor means the climate, if any kind of flood is there, any kind of drought season is there, any kind of lopping, defoliation exercise has to be conducted there. So external information also you are able to get through this increment boring exercise. I hope now the things is clear to all of you. Now we are moving to the next. Again, this instrument that is required to conduct our exercise. So, measuring tape, you all know that. Folding system rule, chisel and mallet, we require that. This I have just added two instrument extra. Pressure increment borer, tree caliper. Then we need book of printed forms. Then we have a notebook, set of graph papers and pencil eraser. Right. So, these are the instrument that need to be carried out, right? And these are almost common tools that one must have. Why do we are entering in the forest area? So these are certain common tools that need to be carried by the forester to get any kind of, or to draw any kind of data, or to get collect any kind of data from the forest or from the tree itself. Is it clear? So let me one by one. So again, measuring tape, you all know that. So 30 meter, 50 meter, 10 meter, as per your convenience, you can hold measuring tape. Then 60 centimeter rule for folding. Scale has been there, that need to be have with you. Then chisel and mallet, in the last class I've already discussed with you, chisel and mallet also, in stem and stamp analysis, I've discussed this instrument there. Then we have this instrument that I have there, there's a Pressler's increment borer. Pressler's increment borer. So these are this kind of instrument that you are able to see that. So this instrument is a three part. This is called handle, auger and extractor tree. Right. I'll discuss in detail also, okay, how this instrument has to work when I discuss the procedure, right? But here I am since introducing the instrument only, so you just know the instrument, right? So this instrument has a three part, that is handle, auger and extractor tray, right? And when you get this instrument from, for example, you are supposed to get from the market, so you so all these two component, right, two component will be inside this handle. Handle is bit hollow pipe, is kind of hollow pipe, right? So when you supposed to get this instrument, when you supposed to buy the instrument, so these two part will be inside that. Then you have to open this lock here, and then you are able to get this two other component. Is it okay? So these things you should understand, because sometimes what I mean, if you supposed to see this pressure increment and you get surprised, only one handle I am able to see, where the other two components, so both the component will get inside there, because the handle is a bit hollow, is a bit hollow pipe like that. Is it okay? So that is pressure increment, and how this function I'll discuss when I'll discuss the process or the procedure for increment boring. Is it okay? So this is Pressler's increment borer. I hope the thing is clear. Have you got the instrument? Okay. Then another tree caliper, you all are very familiar with this. There is a tree caliper, we have to use that. Tree caliper, how the things has been fixed there, that has been shown in the image itself, how the things has to be used. How this instrument you are able to use that tree caliper, we have discussed in detail also. So you are a bit familiar with this instrument. Then obviously these are the bottle of water you can carry when you are doing the field exercise. These are some common things that you must have. Bottle of water, strong pocket knife is also required there. Then this notebook, pencil and erasers to record all the data that you are supposed to collecting by doing your exercise on the field. And then set of graph papers so that you can draw this edge diameter relationship or other kind of curve that need to be drawn here. Is it okay? And then there are set of printer, because all this recorded data has to be right somewhere, isn't it? Whatever the information you are collecting, whatever the exercise that you are performing in the field, that need to be that need to be stored here. So I hope this table is clear to all of your screen. Yes or no? Is it clear? So you just look at this column, there's a diameter class. This is a tree number, you are able to see that tree number you have. Then you just look at this is a DBH OB, right? Diameter, breast height, over bar. Then we have a DBH UB, DBH UB you have. Then widths of five rings. Just look at this line, widths of five rings in centimeter. Widths of five rings, five widths of five rings in centimeter we have. Is it clear? Then this is diameter class 0 to 10, you look at there, then 0 to 20, and then all this information has to be written over the tree number 1, tree number 2, then diameter, D1, D2, and then average again, D1, D2, average, this is over bark, this is under bark, right? Then R1, R2, ring is a width of 5 rings in a centimeter, so R1, R2, then total diameter, R1 plus R2. Is it okay? So this is that form number 1 that need to be filled first. Is it okay? It means what the data that you required here. So you need the diameter class, number of tree, how many number of trees you are counting. For example, 2 trees you have taken that only. Then DBH over bark need to be calculated, DBH under bar, and then width of the ring. This need to be calculated. Right? This is a table number, form number 1. Then we have a form number 2 that also need to be used here. There are 3 forms that had to be used here. So this is table form number 2 that you are able to see here. So all this information has been, again, this is a serial number, fine. This is age, there this is final age, this is final age. So the formula has been written over there. Final edge means column 3. Column 3 plus edge to reach lowest diameter. Column 3 plus edge to reach lowest diameter. Is it okay? That need to be here. And then similarly, initial diameter under bar, then we have the increment, then final diameter under bar, then we have a twice bar thickness against diameter of column 4, and then diameter over bar. Again, you have to collect this information, has to be written over there. Is it okay? And then we have a last form, form number 3. So this is the bar thickness table. That is bar thickness table. So again, you understand simply, you have to write the bar thickness only. So you just look at the diameter class. We have tree number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have a diameter over bar, diameter under bar, TBT total bar thickness, then average diameter under bar, and then average total bar thickness has to be written on this form. So basically three forms has been there. So whenever you are collecting data, you have to record the data in all this form number 1, 2, 3. Is it okay? Have you get that, all of you? Have you understand all these three forms? Is there any question? Okay, so you all get that. So now let's start this procedure. So these are the five stages that need to be followed for increment boring: the selection of trees, preliminary works, increment boring, and also radial core and bark measurement. So one by one we'll explain, and I like to make you understand all this process, right? So it's not so difficult to understand. So first, selection of trees, right? So that the first thing that you need to understand here, right, this increment boring exercise has to be done in standing trees, not felled trees. Is it clear? That the first thing that one student should know. So that's why selection of tree is important. Here we have to select one standing tree, not felled tree. So for increment boring, this is the first important thing one should know and always keep in mind, right? This increment boring exercise has to be done on standing tree. Then after that you have to generalize for entire crops for years to come. Is it okay? So again, I have already discussed you how the selection of tree has been done in stem analysis and stem analysis. The same kind of exercise has to be done again there, that the tree should be in typical in shape, size and form, should be straight, free from any disease, any damage, any brokerage, and it should going to represent the whole crop and should not be isolated. Is it clear? You have get that. And since here one thing you have to understand here, since we are not supposed to fell any tree here, so you can have a number of trees, you can select number of trees as per your convenience to get the satisfactory result. Is it clear? So generally what the advisable is there, at least select 2 to 3 trees for each diameter class. Have you get that? Because we are not supposed to fail the tree, so you are free, you can select as much number as per your caliber, as per your capacity to do the work. But generally it is advisable at least select 2 to 3 trees, 2 to 3 trees for each diameter class. Is it okay? Have you get that? Right? And how the things can be done there? So obviously, for example, it's very difficult for do a common single person or two or three persons. So we can increment boring exercise can be done in a group. For example, you know that in our class we have around 90 students, so we can make 10 group, right? 9 student each, and each group is providing one diameter class. The things will be very simple, isn't it? Each group will getting one diameter class. You have to collect all the data for that particular diameter class. So what the things will be done through this? So through this we are also going to avoid the repetition of work, because each group has to perform one diameter class work. Have you get that? So through this we have to do the selection of tree procedure. Is it okay to all of you, all the students? Is the concept clear? Good. I hope the thing is clear to all of you. Or is there any question if people can ask? You have 30 seconds. If you have any question, you can ask. Okay, so no question. Now this preliminary, after that, this work has to be done, preliminary works. So as you know, that preliminary basic information need to be collected there. Right, it means all this longitude, latitude, all this information related to this. And after that, two important work has to be done there. First important work is DVH, and DVH need to be calculated. DVH need to be calculated here, right? DVH both overbark and underbark. This in this preliminary, you have to do that. Overbark and both underbar has to be recorded here in preliminary works. How the things can be done? So as you see that we have already carried one instrument, tree caliper. So using that tree caliper, we are able to perform this OB and this. So let me back to the slide there so that I am able to make you understand again. Where is this? You just look at here, tree caliper. So you have to fix the caliper like that, and we need a two data, one from this side and one perpendicular from this side. Is it clear? If you're taking this side, then take this side perpendicular to this, right? So both the two data is, then we have to record the average diameter. That is important. And if both the diameter is same, so obviously tree is in a cylindrical shape, otherwise it is a bit elliptical. That need to be understood. So we are using the tree caliper for that purpose, to calculate diameter, overbark and diameter. So if you are fixing like that, if you look at the image, so we are able to get the diameter overbark. Then what you have to do? So using this chisel and mallet, you can remove certain portion of bark from here, certain portion of bark from here, and again fix this caliper. You are able to get the DVH under bark. Have you get that? The concept is clear. So in this preliminary, basically these things has to be performed, right? First thing, what the things has to perform? So first you collect all this basic information related to the stand, where it is situated, what kind of climate, these are the works. And then this is important, we have to calculate, you have to record this DBH OB and DBH UB, and then you have to record all this information in form number one. As you have seen the form number one, we have got two column for this, isn't it? DBH overbark, DBH underbark. So we can record all this data in form number one. As you look at the DVH overbark, DVH underbark. I hope you all get that. The concept is clear up to this point. Or is there any question you people can ask? Is there any question? Okay, so you all get that. Now increment boring, the another important, this is important because we are doing increment boring exercise, so this exercise need to be understand. So now try to understand this. So you look at the image, how the things has to be done there, right? We have a handle, we have auger. The first handle and auger to be fixed, and then it need to pierce into a tree, right? Then you have to rotate it clockwise so that you are able to insert into the tree stream. Is it clear? Listen carefully again. Again, I am showing you. As you look at there, from very first, this is the first stage. You guys, there is one. Have you seen that? There is one simple instrument with the hand of an observer. So, as I told you, all these two components inside this. Fine. So, you just look at here. Right. So, after that, first. This second, what you have to do, second, just look at it, this will be the second step that need to be followed here. What you have to do, you just open the lock and you get all both the part, this two part extractor and those auger, and then you fix auger with handle. As you look at there, you have to fix auger with handle and then you have to pierce it, and then you need to rotate it clockwise. Just rotate it clockwise, right, so that it is going to insert into the tree stem. And what the things that you have to be, you are not supposed to put so much force, otherwise it will get damaged. So push gentle force is required there, and then you're going to rotate it, it will going to insert into the tree stem. And again, only through the guesswork you have to insert till the half of the tree diameter, till the half of the tree diameter. So just look at it, means if this is, and if this is center, so at least pierce up to the center, and only through the guesswork you can know that. But still there is one simple method that you can use, how the things can be done there. If so you just look at here, for example we have a tree stem, right? So before inserting this auger, just place the auger on this stem outside, right, and then make one mark here and also make a mark on the auger. Is it clear? For example, here to work, what is the mark, and then pierce up to that portion into the tree stem. So tentatively you are able to be there, you are able to pierce the auger at least to the core area of tree stem. Have you get this step here? Is it clear? First two stage, have you understand that? Fine. And after that, what you have to do, when you think that, and when you when you convince that you have already pierced this increment borer up to this middle point, then you use this extractor inside that. You just pierce this this extractor into this auger and then do anti-clockwise movement. Just two or three movement is required. So what will happen, when you insert this extractor and two or three anti-clockwise movement will be there, then whatever the wood that you have extracted through auger, it will going to fix on this extractor. Is it okay? And then you have to remove the extractor, so you will get this kind of thing there. Have you understand how the increment borer has to be used? All of you get this concept here, how the increment borer we can use here? Fine. So after that you will get this part of wood, and how it look like that. So let me throw this next slide. So it will be look like that. Is it clear? Just look at here, and this is a more closer look I have made that for that same piece. And now you can clearly see, you can clearly see how you can identify something there. You people are a bit intelligent, I know that. So you need to understand, so this is a bit dark portion. Have a look at this, this is dark, so it means this is center, as you know that, because hardwood is in center and hardwood is bit dark. So this is center, you can easily understand that. And from there, then it means this is pith, or you simply you can say this is pith, right? So if you look at that, this is pith 2 and this is final cambium, right? As you look at here, have you get that? And then you have to count all these rings. So if this, this is dark, then what I'm saying, this is light color, dark color, then again light color, dark color, 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 and again you have to count it. So you are able to estimate the age. Have you get that? You are able to estimate the age, and also you can clearly know that that during this what I'm saying, during this spring time you will get this light color, and during the summer you will get this dark color here, right? So these are the information you are able to collect. Without felling the tree, you are able to estimate the age of the tree also. And here some more information, I as I told you, very interesting information you are able to draw. What the information you are able to draw here, just look at here. As I told you, this is light color, it means spring wood, dark color, summer wood, it means in this time the summer season is there, this time bit winter or bit spring kind of things will be there. It is pith because it be core, because it is a bit dark here. And the one more information you are able to get there, very interesting information, if you look at here, this is dark, this is dark. You just look at the difference. And now come here, you just look at the difference, dark and dark. You just look at the difference. As we move from pit to cambium, right, there is a narrowness in between both the rings. So what it signifies? So there is one important, again very interesting fact that you are able to get there. If it is broad, it means in initial state there is no competition or very less competition the tree has to face, and when competition becomes more and more, you'll get more closer both the rings. So this is some information I've discovered. Apart from that, lots of this information we're able to draw from this annual ring. Is it okay? I hope you have all understand this concept here. How this increment boring instrument has to be used. And what are the interesting information that I've shared with all of you? I hope you all have get that and are going to enjoy that information also. Is it okay? Now after that we have to analyze the radial core. So as I and that I have already discussed with you, that is the radial core. It means, see, it is a complete one cross section, you are able to see that. But what we are doing through this increment borer, we are just piercing increment borer like that and that, and then we are getting this piece of wood from the tree. Is it clear? Have you get that? This is a simple exercise we have to done there. Right, where we are piercing this increment borer and there we are extracting this part of things there, and then we are analyzing this radial core. We are analyzing this radial core. Is it clear? And how the exercise can be done there? So now listen carefully, certain facts that need to be noted here. So when you get this radial core out from this, it means when you get this out from this tree stem, what the exercise that need to be done there, listen carefully. First thing, you have to measure the length of, you have to measure the length of outermost 5 ring on one end of each of 2 diameter. Is it clear? Length of outermost 5 rings on one end of each of 2 diameter, right? So why we need that? So that you are able to know the diameter increment it last 5 years. Is it clear? And then you have to record this data again in form number 1 as diameter class wise. Is it have you get that? So through this you are able to get this diameter increment there. Fine. Now go for this bark measurement. So again, it's not a big exercise, as you all know that. Is it okay? So as we can remove certain portion of bark from here, and then you are able to get the bark thickness. It's not so difficult thing. We have to measure the bark thickness from bark measurement exercise. Is it okay? So that you are able to establish the relation between diameter over bark and diameter under bark, right? And then you have to note it down, this average value of diameter under bark and total bark thickness in form number 3. As you have seen that in form number 3, we have to incorporate all those information there. I hope up to this, all these 5 stages you have understand that all these 5 procedure or the process or the field work that need to be done on the tree to do this increment boring exercise. Again, I am repeating what the field work that you have to do. The first selection of trees, then preliminary works, then increment boring, then analysis of radial core, and finally the bark measurement. So this 5 procedure they need to be followed for increment boring. Is it okay? Or if you have any question till this point, you people can ask. Is there any question? No question at all, I assume, because none of you are asking anything. And after that, obviously, when you'll get this data, so using that data, you have to draw three curve. First, diameter, underbark, total bark thickness curve, diameter increment curve, and edge diameter curve. And since we have all these three forms, all this data has been already recorded there. So we have to use only those data and the graph paper, and we can draw all these three curves here. Is it okay? And if you look at the image, so this will be the diameter underbark TBT curve number one. Is it okay? This is the diameter. Total bark thickness, and this is diameter underbark, and you can make this curve here. Have you get that? Then similarly, similarly you can get the diameter increment curve. Again, you can use this form, whatever the form that you have filled, that form number one, form number two, form number three. You have to use all these three forms to draw any kind of curve that you need to have. Is it clear? Diameter increment curve, then after that you have to draw this diameter edge curve. That curve I have discussed you several times, even in the stamp analysis I have discussed you how this diameter edge curve has to be drawn. So we have to do the same thing here. Is it okay? This all about for this increment boring. So if you people have any question, you can ask.